Hi there, my name is Helen Weber and today I want to show you how to install .NET Core and Visual Studio Code on a Mac. The Cloud Academy C# programming learning path starts with the Introduction to C# course, where I show you how to set up a development environment on Windows and Ubuntu. Having demonstrated this process on the first and third most popular desktop operating systems, it's only proper to include the second, macOS. .NET Core is a cross-platform development and runtime environment, and C# is a fully featured object-oriented language. .NET Core and C# have a large user base and extensive libraries, and their functionality is constantly evolving and expanding with the considerable resources of Microsoft behind it. First off, let's download and install the .NET 5.0 SDK, Software Development Kit, from dotnet.microsoft.com/download. I'll grab the macOS x64 SDK installer that includes runtime software libraries for .NET 5 and ASP.NET Core. Once that's downloaded, we can install it like any other software package by clicking on it and following the installer wizard. I'll enter my password to authorize the installation. We can verify the installation by opening a terminal window and typing the .NET list SDKs command, which returns the version and the installation location. Next, we'll install Visual Studio Code by going to code.visualstudio.com and downloading the Universal Stable Build. Once downloaded, I'll open VS Code and install the C# language support extension. Click on the extensions icon in the left-hand vertical toolbar and search for C# for Visual Studio Code. When you find it, click the blue install button. I know dark themes are popular, but I'm not a fan, so I'll set the color theme to Visual Studio 2019 Lite. Now that we've set up the .NET Core and VS Code, let's create a simple boilerplate console application with the .NET command line interface. Before making the app, I'll create a directory structure for my C# projects. So that's projects, C#, and Hello Mars. Within the Hello Mars directory, I'll run the .NET new command for a console application with the O parameter for the app name, as I did in both Windows and Ubuntu. When I run an ls command, we can see the Hello Mars project directory gets created. Now I can open the project in VS Code with the code dot command, except I can't. As the message says, the command code is unknown. I can make macOS aware of the code command through VS Code. I'll shut down the terminal window and open up VS Code. Show the command palette by pressing the F1 key or Shift plus Command plus P and start typing shell in the search box until you see shell command install code command in path. Then select it. Enter your password when prompted to install the code command. Now that's done, we can go back to the Hello Mars project directory in the terminal and type code dot. which opens VS Code with our C# project. As this is the first time running a .NET C# project, supporting language libraries are downloaded and installed. When you open a C# project, VS Code, or rather the C# extension, prompts you to set up all the libraries and assets needed to build and debug the application. I'll click Yes to that. In the top left, a new directory gets added called .vscode, which contains some configuration files for the project. Let's make a few changes to the Boilerplate console application by changing Hello World to Hello Mars. The first Hello World program was written in 1972 using a language called B, the precursor to C, which in turn is the ancestor of most of today's programming languages. Yes, there's a small typo which I'll fix up shortly. I'll also grab the first argument from the args array and assign it to a string variable called myName. I explain args, arrays, and variables in the first two courses of the C# learning path. But briefly, arrays are collections of data, like a list, where each item can be accessed with a numerical index, and the first item has the index 0, not 1. My name is appended to the Hello Mars literal text with a plus operator. I'll open up launch.json from the VS Code folder. Launch.json tells VS Code what to do when I run a program from within VS Code. As I'm accessing the first value from the args array, I need to make sure there is at least one item in the array, or else the program will throw an error. I think Elon is an appropriate name. With that done, I'll run the program from within VS Code by selecting Run Without Debugging. There we go. Hello Mars from Elon. But still with a typo. I'll fix that, save and run again. Okay, cool. Let's run the program from within .NET via the command line. We need to dig down into bin, debug, and .NET 5.0 to run .NET with the compiled hellomars.dll passing in Elon as an argument. There we go. If you want to learn C# .NET programming, join me at Cloud Academy for the C# learning path, where I take you from zero to hero. The courses cover C# programming in Windows, Linux, and macOS, where I pay special attention to cross-platform features offered by .NET Core and how to integrate and leverage Azure cloud technology. See you there.